Good morning, teachers and fellow classmates. I'm Deepak, and my fellow members are Gwenya, Jovi, Jashan, and Simlo. And the task we have chosen is task 3, and it's about food wastage. The information which is required to accomplish the task is how much food had been wasted over the past 10 years, and what is the growing population over 10 years. We have to know these informations for us to carry out to find the average for the next 10 years. As information provided, there is an increase in food wastage because of Singapore's growing population. Over the past 10 years, food wastage has increased by 20%.
What are some assumptions we have thought of? The growing population is constantly increasing, and the amount of food wastage is also increasing. So over the next decade, the amount of food wastage should also decrease. Why is there an increase in food wastage? Shortly after the Dostcon level is raised from yellow to orange, there's a wave of panic buying. Politicians and supermarkets call for calm, stressing that Singapore has enough stocks of essential supplies and food. This means that there is a high chance of food being wasted because people are panic buying the food which expires very quickly, which leads to them throwing the food away earlier. This is the pie chart which represents the total population of Singapore. Nextly, this is the statistics for the total population and total food wastage over the next decade. The total population is represented in millions, and the total food wastage is represented in 1,000 tons.
So, for Plan A, we want to find the number increase over the past 10 years and assume that the yearly percentage increase over the next 10 years is the same. So, to find the amount of food waste over the next 10 years. So, this is the solution we came up with. So, while carrying out Plan A, is that we use the percentage, which is the total percentage increase in 10 years, the total percentage difference between each year from 2009 to 2019, divided by the total population from 2009 to 2019, and then times 100, we will get 1.16%. After that, we will find the total percentage increase of food wastage in 10 years, and we will get 1.26%. So, assuming that the rate of increasing population and increasing food waste wastage remains the same down the next 10 years from 2019 to 2029, the total population in 10 years would estimated to be 6613596, and the estimated total tons of food waste in the next 10 years would be 937000 tons. So as you can see over here, this is the Singapore population from 2009 to 2019. The blue color is the total population, the red color one is the total food wastage. Next, this is our proof for Plan A over the next 10 years. So, the blue color one is 2019 and the red color one is 2039. As you guys can see, there's an increase in both population and food wastage.
This is our second solution, Plan B. In Plan B, we use the general difference between 2009 and 2019, and to find the population over the next 10 years, we add it to the total population in 2019. The general difference, which is 69823, and when we add it to the total population in 2019, 10 years later, we got 6384041 population. This is the chart to prove that from 2009 to 2019, the population is increasing, and from 2019 to 2029, the population is also increasing. Next, this is to prove that the food waste increases. We use the same method by using the general difference between 2009 and 2019 and add it to the total food waste in 2019, which is 881,000 tons. This is a chart to show that from 2009 to 2019, the food waste increases, and from 2019 to 2029, the food waste increases. So for Plan C, we have decided to use a method where we add the constant of X and to find the increase in the total population after 10 years and to find the estimated population. So firstly, we start by letting X be the constant of 2009, and for the next 10 years of the population, use X plus the value of 2019, which is 4987573 plus 5024915, which gives you 10012488. And we use the same method to find the tons of food waste for the next 10 years, which is X plus the value of 2019 which is 607000 plus 1413000, which gives you 2020000 tons. So after all these methods, what have we settled on? We decided to settle on Plan A as the answer is more accurate compared to the other plans. We calculated the difference increase one by one so that the result estimated is much more accurate, and it is also shown by the answer. The increase between 2009 to 2019 is near to the number of cases from 2019 to 2029. So reflecting on the real world situation, my group and I thinks that it is adequate, but we can improve it by gathering more specific and detailed information to make our solution more accurate. But this was not possible because we were unable to find all the variables and their values accurately.
Reflecting on the real-world solution, for example, we did not find the population for the years 2020 and 2021. Hence, we faced difficulties such as attaining the average amount of food waste for a decade. This resulted in us getting stuck after a few steps and were not able to move on as we attained an unknown value.
How can your modeling strategy be extended to related problems? For that, we estimated the total amount of electronic waste produced in Singapore over the next decade. We can find total amount of electric waste for the past 10 years from 2010 to 2020, 2020 to 2030, to the future according to the average percentage increase. Assuming that it is the same, multiply the original waste to find the total electronic waste in 2030.
So this is our individual reflection for the math modeling project. So this program helped me to gain more knowledge about food waste and the consequences of it if we continue to waste food.
For me, through this program, I learned to share my thoughts with my teammates, and I learned to apply past knowledge to come up with the solution to solve the problem. On top of this, I also learned that teamwork is very important, as with teamwork, we can cooperate well so that we can get things done. I feel that this activity was very enriching for me. Through this program, I learned how to work with others who I was originally not close with and come up with as many methods as possible for our task. On top of that, I also learned that there are many different approaches to a common question.
This math program was very engaging as I stepped out of my comfort zone and cooperated with others who I did not know very well. This resulted in me getting to know more people, and it helped me attain a solution to an actual real-world problem by working together as a team.
This activity was very fun as I managed to get close with my groupmates whom which I wasn't close with at first, and I learned that through working together we can come up with great ideas.
Okay, now we'll proceed to the Q&A.
These are the handsome pictures of us which we took during our group work. Thank you for your wonderful listening, yes.